Welcome to Heart of the Matter. Radio friends, it is another time again. Get your radio set to listen to God speak to you now. I have just ended speaking to the singles, but I want to go to another thing today, to talk still on the family and go to where the devil has been dealing with us. And I believe that the Lord will bless you as we reason from God's word. A word of prayer is important. Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you. Bless your name. Because of your faithfulness, loving kindness and mercy, grace that has been upon your children. I pray, Lord, as I read your word, as I deliver your word will go out with power, unction, and anointing. Holy Spirit of God, back up your word. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen. I told you this is Heart of the Matter. Never miss the program because there is always something new for you to learn. Let's go into the message. I'm talking about sheltering the family from satanic attacks. We all know that the devil is after the family. As we look into the scriptures from the onset, from the beginning of Genesis, we discover the very first family that God created was attacked by the devil. And unfortunately, the devil succeeded in causing confusion and separating the family from God. Another family that we must recognize to show you that the devil is after the family is the family of Job. Wonderful, wonderful man of God, wonderful priest. And this family was attacked by the devil, and the devil did a lot of havoc. And he is still doing those havocs today. That is what I want to examine in this Heart of the Matter, so that we know how to attack the devil and how to put the devil where he belongs. Let me go into the scriptures. I'm reading Genesis. Book of Genesis chapter 3. I'm reading the first attack on the family by the devil. Genesis chapter 3. I'm reading from verse number 1. Now the serpent was more subtle than every beast of the field which the Lord God had made. And he said unto the woman, yea, had God said, ye shall not eat of every tree of the garden? And the woman said unto the serpent, we may eat of the fruit of the tree of the garden, but of the fruit of the tree which is in the midst of the garden, God has said, ye shall not eat of it, neither shall ye touch it, lest ye die. This was the first attempt of the devil. You know, that God has created Adam and Eve and placed them in the garden, married them together, wedded them together. These were husband and wife, and the devil saw the blessings of God and saw the pronouncements of God upon their life, which was be fruitful and multiply and replenish the earth. The devil was jealous. Can I hear your amen? The devil is jealous against your family. The devil is jealous of your wife. He's jealous of your husband. He's jealous of the progress that your children are making in academics and spiritually. So he will want to step in order to scatter that family, in order to break that family. And I'm telling you the truth, he attacked the family of Adam here, and lo and behold, Adam was not watchful enough, and he prevailed against that family, and that is why his children, his descendants, which we are today, we are still suffering the effect. Let me tell you something, if the devil attacks your family and succeeds, your generation is going to suffer, your children are going to suffer, and the effect of the demonic defeat will be visible in your family, will be visible in your life, will be visible in the life of your children, as we are suffering the same effect today. And I pray that as I look at the scriptures today to expose to us those things which we need to know, God will help us in the name of Jesus. I'm looking at Job, I'm reading Job chapter 2. Reading is verse number 4. And the Bible says, and Satan answered the Lord and sent skin for skin, yea, all that the man had will he give for his life. Verse number 7. So when Satan fought from the presence of God and smote Job with sore boils from the sole of his foot unto his crown. Verse number 8. And he took him a potage to scrape himself without, and he sat down among the ashes. Verse number 9. Then said his wife unto him, dost thou still retain thy integrity? Curse God and die. But he said unto her, thou speaketh as one of the foolish women speaketh. What shall we receive good from the hand of God, and shall we not receive evil? In all this, did not Job sin with his lips? We are seeing a righteous man here, the man called Job. Hallelujah. This man was attacked, his family was attacked by the devil, and the devil did a lot of havoc because of his ignorance. You know, at times it is ignorance. My people perish for lack of knowledge, and we also perish for ignorance. When we don't know who we are in Christ Jesus, we don't know the provision of God for our families, we don't know what God had destined for our families, we will allow the devil to have his way into the family, and at times we ascribe those evil that happen to us and happen to our families to God like Job. Many of us will say all things work together for good, but put it in context, it's not everything that works together for our good. There are things that the devil is doing to us and we think they're working for our good. They are not working for our good. Brother, sister, sit up. Come on, the Bible says that Job ascribed the suffering, the afflictions, the troubles, the destruction, the devastation. He said, should we receive only good things from God and we don't receive evil things too? Can you imagine this? Can we receive bad things from God, evil things from God? God does not give evil things to his children. Good things come from God, and no good thing, the Bible says, no good thing will he withhold from his children. How come about that Job is now telling us that bad things we also receive from God, evil things we also receive from God? This is ignorance. And the death, because of ignorance, many families are suffering today. Husbands are fighting their wives. Wives are fighting their husband. Children are fighting their parents because they don't know that the devil is sitting at the center of the family and is controlling the husband, is controlling the wife, is controlling the children, and is knocking their heads together. Instead of facing the devil, as Job and his wife here, instead of them facing the devil, they turned and they were facing God. And that is how the devil knew that they were ignorant of his presence. They were ignorant of his activity. And he went on and went on and went on and destroyed unto the last thing that Job had, which was his health. I pray the devil will not destroy your health in the name of Jesus Christ. Come on, brother and sister, keep listening. Let me read you something here that the devil is taking advantage of. 2 Corinthians chapter 2. I'm reading from verse number 11. 2 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 11. Lest Satan should get advantage over us. We are not ignorant of the devices of the devil. I thank the Lord for Paul the apostle when he was talking to the Corinthian Christians. You know, before saying what he's saying here, let me show you something before I say what I want to say. Look at chapter 10. Chapter 10 of the same 2 Corinthians. Look at what he said. From verse number 3, for though we walk in the flesh, we do not war after the flesh. For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds. Can I hear you? Amen. That is why he told the Corinthian Christians that lest the devil will get advantage over you. We are not ignorant of his devices. That is why he says Satan has strongholds, and he has made strongholds in people's home. He has made strongholds in people's family, and the families are scattered, and the world is suffering today because of the attack of the devil upon the family. And I pray that the ignorance that is inside your family, the Holy Ghost and the revelation of his word will blow it off in the name of Jesus Christ. I pray that the devil will be exposed, his activity will be exposed, and everything that he has done to your family. Come on, brother, you will rise up with your family and will defeat defeat the devil and put that man where he belongs. He has no where he belongs. He doesn't have any part in your hand. He doesn't have any part on your back, on your heart. He doesn't have any part. Where the devil belongs is under our feet, and we shall trample upon him, and our family shall be saved in the name of Jesus Christ. There are many pastors today whose family, whose children have removed them from the pulpit. Do you think it is for nothing, brother? Do you think it is the doing of God? It is the devil's plan to remove pastors from pulpit. He's destroying pastors' home, destroying pastors' children, causing them to be wayward, and the church is sitting, and we are looking at the devil to the face, and we don't know, we are ignorant, that the devil is doing this to hinder the gospel of the kingdom, to hinder the propagation of the gospel of his son Jesus. And I pray that no minister will drop from the pulpit in the name of Jesus Christ. Holy Spirit will help you. The power of God, the anointing of the Holy Spirit. And I pray that as you open your mouth, fire will come out. As you open your mouth, power will come out. As you open your mouth, the devil will pack his bag and baggages and escape in the name of Jesus. That thing that the devil is doing in your home, I am telling you, Paul said, the weapons of our warfare, they are not carnal. They are not carnal. We don't use carnal weapons. That is why we are suffering today, because husband is using carnal weapons against the wife. You are the cause of this problem. You are the trouble in this home. You are the one who is bringing problem here. It is this, our children, that are causing us trouble. Your children are not causing you trouble. The devil is the one causing the trouble. Recognize the devil and kick him off in the name of Jesus. Holy Spirit will help you. I'm looking at three things, then I will pray. Number one, identify satanic attacks on the family. Let's identify areas that the devil creeps into the family and attacks the home. Number two, irresistible weapons for destroy satanic attacks on the family. Then number three, employ godly virtues to counter satanic attacks on the family. Come on, brother, sister. God is about doing something. Let's go to point number one. Identifying satanic attacks on the family. I want to read to you again from that first 2 Corinthians chapter 10. I'm reading from verse number 3. From verse number 3, the Bible says, for though we walk in the flesh, for though we walk in the flesh, we do not war after the flesh. For the weapons of our warfare, for the weapons of our warfare. That means there is a warfare that is already ongoing. Hallelujah. Come on, don't be ignorant. The Bible said the weapons of our warfare, if God is equipping us with his weapon, it's because there is a battle to fight. You cannot equip a soldier when there is no battle. You are training soldiers and arming them because there is an enemy for them to fight. Believers have been armed with weapons that are not used. Believers are armed with weapons that are not used. The weapons are warfare. Why are you using them? And the devil is still doing the things he's doing in your family. And the devil is still doing the things he's doing with your children. And he's still manipulating you. And you put money here, he takes it away. You put money here, he takes it away. And devourers are here and there. I pray that the power of God will come upon your family today. And by the mighty hand of Jesus, the devil will see fire and begin to pack his load and pack his bag and pack his baggages and disappear in the name of Jesus Christ. For the weapons of our warfare, they are not carnal, but mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds, strongholds of the devil, strongholds of the enemy, strongholds of demonic forces, strongholds of demon spirit that are operating in your home, pulling them down, breaking them down. Number five, verse number five, the Bible says, casting down every imagination and every high thing that exalts itself against the knowledge of God, and bringing into captivity. Come on, every captive will be free. We are going to bring the captor into captivity. Can I hear you? Amen. We bring the devil into captivity, his demon into captivity, and the people of God will be free. The Bible says, if the Son therefore shall make you free, ye shall be free and free indeed. I pray that total, complete freedom that the Lord has accorded for us will be yours and your family, and we shall live heaven on earth families in the name of Jesus Christ. May the Lord bless your soul. I move ahead. I want to read you something in Joshua chapter 6. Joshua chapter 6. Come on, brother, open your Bible. If you don't have your Bible, you are in your marketplace, please come on, begin to listen. If you are on your way to work, begin to listen. If you are now in your home, begin to listen. Look at chapter 6. Chapter 6, I'm reading verse 1. Now Jericho was strictly shut because of the children of Israel, and none went out and none came in. I pray that this will be the nature of our home, that we will build a security around our family, that the devil will not come in and nobody will go out to the devil. No child in the family, no husband in the family, no wife in the family will go out there. We shut the doors of our home against the devil and against his activities in the name of Jesus. I pray that the power of the Holy Ghost, as I pray right now, I feel the Spirit will come upon your life. The power will come upon your life. The Holy Ghost will come upon your life. While you are still listening to this message in your home, the devil will begin to pack his bag and baggages. And I'm going to pray after this message, and the fire of God, wherever you are, if you are holding your phone, the power of God will pass through that and enter into your family. Wherever you are, the hand of God is ready today to deliver you and to set you free. There are some people, the devil is sitting on the brain of their children. Children cannot succeed. Children cannot make it. Family cannot make it. No progress. You are 50 years today, no house. You are 50 years today, no still renting. And everything you walk, the devil will scatter. You struggle with this. You struggle with this. And the devil is sitting on your head. I pray the devil will come out this day in the name of Jesus Christ. Look at how Jericho did it. Jericho did it well. They build a security around the city. Can we build a spiritual fence? You know the devil? The devil told God, listen to me, brother, sister. The devil told God, hey, do you know who Job is? I know who Job is. You have built a hedge around Job, around his property, around his children. I pray that that spiritual hedge that cannot be broken by the enemy, that formidable fence and spiritual hedge will be built around your life, around your wife, around your children, around your property, and the devil will have nowhere to do in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, God, brother. God bless you. Let me read you Ephesians. Come on, open your Bible. Ephesians chapter 12, chapter 6. Let me read verse 10 first. Before I read to verse number 12, verse number 10. Finally, brethren. Hallelujah. Finally, brethren, be strong. Hallelujah. You know what the devil has done is that he has paralyzed people spiritually. He has paralyzed the husband, he cannot pray. He has paralyzed the wife cannot pray. He has paralyzed the children. He has paralyzed everybody in the family. He has paralyzed no power of the Holy Ghost. He has sapped on the whole family of spiritual strength. And now the family is operating carnally and having troubles. The Bible tells us, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. In the power of his might. And the Bible says, put on the whole armor. If you are putting on the whole armor, brother, it is because you know the devil is around. It is because you know the enemy is around. And put up the whole armor that ye may be able. If you don't put the armor, you will not be able. If you don't put the armor, you will not be able to resist the wiles of the devil. For we wrestle, brother, it is a battle. Come on. Oh my God, I pray that the Lord Jesus will open your eyes and the Holy Ghost will open your heart, that we are into a spiritual warfare. We are into a battle with the Lord and we are with the devil, and the devil will not give up. We are the ones that are giving up. You know, more than 2,000 years ago, Jesus Christ went to Calvary and defeated him and gave us the victory. But we are still slaves. We are still captives in his hand. And the devil is still manipulating us. The Bible says we wrestle. If you don't wrestle, the devil is still wrestling. And I pray that as the devil wrestles, you will wrestle. In the name of Jesus Christ. We wrestle not against flesh and blood. Not fighting your wife. Not fighting your children. Not fighting your husband. Not fighting the members of your family. We wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against the principality. When the Bible talks of principality, there are forces that are in control. control. There are forces that are taking territories. There are forces that have dominion over territories, principalities. They're working against power. Some people sit, come on and tell me that Satan has no power. If Satan has no power, you will not see this in the scripture. If Satan has no power, you will not have this in the word of God. But it will have this in the word of God. Come on, brother, listen to me. It's because the God knows that Satan has power. Satan came from heaven with power. Hallelujah. Let the ignorance of the believer go away. Satan came from heaven with the power. That is why when he was thrown down from heaven, heaven rejoiced. Heaven rejoiced and said, woe unto the inhabitants of the earth, because the devil, that dragon, that old Satan is come down unto you. And we are sitting here making stories and saying Satan does not have power. And Satan is sitting right on your head. Satan is sitting right inside your family. Satan is dominating and controlling your life and controlling your children. And you are sitting and saying, my children are disobedient. My children are wayward. I don't know what to do with these children. You don't know. You don't know. It's because you are ignorant of who the devil is. And you are saying he doesn't have power. He has already dominated you, and I pray that after this message, the devil will have no place in your life, but his place will be under your feet in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Let me move ahead and so that we can get some things done. You know, there is something I want to point out here. I want to point out here. Because if I don't point you at these things, you will not understand where I'm going to. You know, in Daniel chapter 10, verse number 12 and verse number 13, the Bible tells us that Daniel, listen to me. You know, I might not finish the message I want to finish, because there are some things, if I don't point those things to you, the devil will continue to control your home, will continue to rule your home. The Bible said Daniel prayed. Why Daniel was praying? The prince of Persia hindered him, hindered his prayer. And look at this, you have been praying, and the devil is hindering your prayer, and you think that it's just enough for you to sit down and fold your hands and begin to celebrate. Well, how does the devil attack the family? He attacks the family through sicknesses, through chronic diseases, mysterious deaths in the family, incurable diseases. He afflicts the family, afflicts his children, he afflicts the family with barrenness, as he afflicted Sarah, as Hannah was there. He afflicted them with those things. Not only that, he torment and put people into depression through witchcraft, using sorcery, using all kinds of evil powers and evil spirit. Now, number five, he brings curses and yokes and bondages that leads people to sudden death, that lead people to madness, to epilepsy, to infirmities that have no cure. Not only that, he brings mysterious dreams that people cannot sleep because of mysterious dreams. They dream all through the night. They are flying from this corner of the earth, flying to this one. Some say, hey, when I slept in the night today, I saw myself swimming in the river. I saw a python chasing me. I saw jujus in the village chasing me. Those things are demonic dreams. And I prayed, you know, I was sleeping. Somebody came and slept with me in the dream. And I'm having mammoth spirit. I'm having a spiritual husband. Come on, what are you saying? What are you saying? As a child of God, you are telling me that you have mammoth spirit. You are telling me that your demons are sleeping with you. What is it? What is happening with the church today? Where is the fire of the Holy Ghost? I remember a region where I went by the grace of God. That was around 2004. We were in a retreat, and while we were singing, just me singing, fire came down from heaven, literally. And people stood up. There was a woman who was possessed of evil spirit. The woman stood up from her chair and started running all over the field. Another one who came there, he was a musician. He has entered into occultism. Fire came upon him. He fell right in the retreat ground and was shouting fire. Where are these people coming from? And that, you know, that demonic woman, no one was saying, he said, hey, what type of place is this? You sit on this bench here, fire. You sit here, fire. You sit here, fire. You sit here, fire. And today, the fire disappeared. With all kind of motivational thoughts. Come on, brother, we need to go back to the old time gospel. We need to go back to the old time power. That when preaching is going on, people come under anointing. I'm not talking about people falling on their chairs, for and deceiving themselves, they are falling under anointing. I'm talking when the pastor is preaching, when the evangelist is preaching, the fire of God will be chasing those evil spirits. They will cry out in the congregation and jumping out of the lives of people. I pray this will happen again. That's what I'm saying. He afflicts people with those kind of bad dreams, occultism, intimidation, causing children to become wayward, and all these things are happening, bringing stubbornness in the life of children, making children not to obey, that but juvenile delinquency, all things are happening to the children. You don't understand what is going on in the family. It is because of these demonic attacks. There is also attacks on the family project. You start a project, you cannot finish. You start this one, will fail. Start a business project, will fail. Start a family project, will fail. Start a building, will leave it halfway. And you have never carried a project successfully. It's because of those demonic attacks. Brother, sister, you must know these things. If you don't know these things, the devil will continue to do this thing. What he does? He attacks the spirituality of the family, attack the prayer life of the family, bring impurity into the family, bring unfaithfulness into the family, and bring this misunderstanding in the family, and cause the family to live in rebellion like cat and rat in the house. Those are operations of the devil. He brings broken marriages, broken homes, separation in families, and all these things the devil brings just in a bit, to scatter the home, to destroy the home, to frustrate the family, and cause the family to live perpetually in bondage. I pray that bondage will be taken off from your family in the name of Jesus. And if you are a pastor listening to me, and your children are wayward, I want you to go back to your prayer room. Something is wrong. And arrest the devil. You know what they say? Buy him. Some people think buy him is just they don't understand. When the Bible says buy him, is to restrict him. Restrict him. There are some places that the devil must not enter. Listen to me, brother. There are some places that Satan should not enter. The home of a minister of God, Satan shouldn't enter. The home of a believer, Satan should not enter. If he makes a mistake, tell him you have missed the address. Check the next door neighbor. Because we have opened the door today, the devil has free will. He enters the way he wants. He walks the way he wants. He does what he wants. But today, can I hear your amen? Radio friends, can I hear your amen? Today, as you understand the scripture, you understand the word of God, I pray you will begin to kick the devil off in the name of Jesus Christ. Number two, irresistible weapons for destroying satanic attacks against the family. Irresistible weapons. Weapons that cannot be resisted. These weapons have been proven to be strong enough. These weapons have been proven by heaven. You know, let me read you again. In 2 Corinthians chapter 10, don't forget this verse of the scriptures I'm reading. Look at chapter 10 verse 3. For though we walk in the flesh, we are normal people, but we are not the same. But don't walk in the flesh. We do not war after the flesh. For the weapons of our warfare, they are not carnal. Listen to this. They are mighty. Mighty weapons. In the hands of the Christian, in the hands of the believer, the man that God has given, Jesus has given the keys of the kingdom. It said the weapon, they are mighty through God. It is through God. It's not by your own power. Stop all this careless pride. That you see pride everywhere. I am a demon caster. I'm a deliverer. I deliver this person. You deliver the person, you didn't. I healed that person, you didn't heal. It is the working of the mighty power of God through the vessel that God uses, through the minister of the gospel. It said these weapons are mighty through God to the pulling down of stronghold. Why is it that stronghold is standing like bulwarks in our homes? Why is it that the devil is standing like Goliath in our home? And we cannot put Goliath where he belongs. We cannot cut off the head of Goliath today. And we can cut David, and we can cut Samson, and cut all those saying it is the weapons is in our hand. Let's pull down and tear the kingdom of darkness and let the devil know that there is an army of people that have been chosen and dedicated by God. Let the devil know that this family you cannot cross. I remember some years back, I think that was around 2000, a demonic woman, you know, Alice was somebody related to us. Then we invited her to come to the house. After she came to the house and went back, do you know what happened? in her kingdom, they told him, they told her, how many did they invite and went into that house? Because when that woman entered the house, was something strange happened. I said, give me your purse. He gave me the purse. As he gave me the purse, I removed a pen from that purse, a razor blade from that purse. I said, where are these things coming from? He started confessing these things like this. They are spiritual, these materials, they are this one. They want this. How could you have entered into that place? Into that place where fire is burning day and night. I didn't see the power of the fire, but the enemy saw the fire. I didn't see the fire, but the power of God was still there. I pray that God will clothe your family with fire. In the name of Jesus Christ. These are the things we're talking about. And I pray as I'm reading the scriptures, the Lord himself will help you and help me. Look at the book of Matthew, chapter 16. Matthew chapter 16, I'm reading verse number 18. Verse number 18, the Bible says, and I say unto thee, that thou art Peter, because of this confession, upon this rock, the rock Jesus, I will build my church, and the gate of hell shall not prevail against it. I will build a family. I will build your family, and the gate of hell will not prevail against your family. If you see Satan prevailing against your family, do you want to tell me that the scripture is not true? The scripture is still true. Up to today, the scripture is still powerful. The word of God is still light. It's still fire. It's still hammer. I pray you use it against the devil in the name of Jesus Christ. And I know by the grace of God, look at somebody like Jesus Christ in Acts of the Apostle, Jesus Christ himself in Acts of the Apostle, chapter 10. I'm reading verse number 38. Chapter 10, verse 38. Chapter 10, verse 38. How God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and with power, who went about doing good, healing all that were oppressed of devils, of the devil, for God was with him. Let me show you something. Let me tell you something here. There are many people who say, we are filled, we are baptized by the Holy Ghost, and there is no power. Go and put that thing in the trash can. Hallelujah! You say you are filled with the Holy Ghost, and there is no fire, there is no power, there is no authority, there is no unction, there is no anointing, there is no manifestation. Then you better check that kind of Holy Ghost. The Bible says Jesus was anointed with the Holy Ghost and with power. And he said when he comes, he will baptize us with the Holy Ghost and with fire. Where is the fire of the Holy Ghost? Where is that fire? That fire is quenching. That fire is going off. And I pray that all of us who will listen to this message, and get the message right there. Get the message there. And by the grace of God, things are going to change in the name of Jesus Christ. Trust me, the Lord has never failed anybody. And he will not fail you in the name of Jesus Christ. Now, let me count you some five of those weapons. Number one is the Word of God. It's the Word of God. The Word of God is quick, powerful. Powerful. Hebrews chapter 4. Hebrews chapter 4, I'm reading verse number 12. The Bible says, for the word of the Lord is quick. For the word of the Lord is quick and powerful and sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing to the dividing asunder and of the spirit and of the joints and of the marrow. And it is the discerner of thought and the intent of the heart. Look at what the Bible says. The word of God is sharp. Hallelujah. Sharp. How is the word of God in your mouth? Preacher, pastor, how is the word of God in your mouth? You preach the word of God and you sleep on the pulpit. There is no fire. While you are still preaching, the whole congregation has gone to sleep. People are bored under your message. I pray that the spirit, the power of the word, the sharp sword of the word will pierce into every heart while you are preaching. And in the family, when you quote the word of God, the power of God will begin to manifest. Hallelujah. That is what the Bible tells us here. That is the power of the God's word in Revelation. Excuse me. In Revelation chapter 12, I'm reading something. Revelation chapter 12. Let me pick through verse number 11. Look at what the Bible says. And they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony. And they loved not their lives unto death. That is the power we see in God's word. It is the sword of the Spirit. It is the sword of the Spirit. And this word will never fail. Number two, victory of the cross. Jesus Christ has given us victory. The cross gave us victory. Gave a dead blow to the devil. And I pray that defeat of Satan on the cross, it is ours and it is yours and it is for your family. Ephesians chapter 1, I'm reading verse number 19 of Ephesians chapter 1. Look at Ephesians chapter 1, verse 19. And what is the exceeding greatness of his power to God's word, who believe according to the working of their mighty power, which he wrought in Christ, when he raised him from the dead and sat him at his right hand, at the right hand, and in the heavenly places, far above principalities and powers, that and might and dominion and every name that is named, not only in this world, but also in the world to come. Although in the world to come, the Bible says God has raised Jesus up. He has raised Jesus up. He has put it up in heavenly places. And that is far above principalities and power. And we are raising up with him. He has raised us up also with him to sit with him in the heavenly places. And also far above principalities. The devil has no power over our life, has no power over our families in the name of Jesus Christ. The cross defeated the devil. Look at John chapter 19, verse number 30. Look at what the Bible says. And Jesus, therefore, when he has received the vinegar, said, "It is finished." And he bowed his head and gave up the ghost. Jesus said, "It is finished." The devil is a finished property. It's a finished property. And if you don't know that the devil was finished on the cross, if you don't know that his powers were finished on the cross, he will continue to use your ignorance to torment your family. In those irresistible weapons, use them for his glory. Use them for your family. Number three is the name of Jesus. It's the name of Jesus. The Bible says the name of Jesus is a strong tower, and the righteous running into it and are saved. The Bible says God has exalted Jesus and has given him a name that is above every name, that at the mention of the name of Jesus, every knee will bow and every tongue will confess. Let the tongues of the devil in your family confess. All those demons that are speaking through your wife, all those demons that are speaking through you, speaking through your children, causing confusion in the family, will rebuke them and let those voices of the devil be silent in the name of Jesus Christ. I know God is doing, God is saying something, and I believe that through his word, something strange is going to happen in your home, it's going to happen in your life in the name of Jesus Christ. The Bible is clear. The Bible says in Philippians chapter 2 verse 10, that at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow. At the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow. That name has conquered the devil already. Just use that name and the devil will find his way out of your home. Number four is the blood of Jesus. We overcome him by the blood of the Lamb that was shed on the cross of Calvary, defeated the devil, separated us from the kingdom of darkness to the kingdom of his dear Son, cleanse us, fill us with the Holy Ghost, and set his fire upon our life. The power of the blood, the efficacy of the blood of Jesus, will not lose its power in the name of Jesus. Number five, the anointing of the Holy Ghost. The Bible tells us in Isaiah chapter 10, verse 27, that by the reason of that anointing, the yoke will be broken. The yoke of the devil in your family will be broken. The yoke of the enemy upon your children will be broken. The yoke of the enemy upon your marriage will be broken. And those who are not married, and the devil is manipulating you, sister, you are getting to 40, you are getting to 30, you are not married, 35, you are not married, 40, you are not married, you are a man, you are 50, you are not married, and you don't know what is happening to you, you go here, there is no headway. I break that chain in the name of Jesus, and I pray that you will be loose, and your marriage will be free. Get up. The devil is doing something, and I pray by the reason of the anointing anointing of the Holy Ghost, that yoke of marital crisis in your life is canceled in the name of Jesus. Hey, you sister who is crying, you say, I don't know when this shall come. You have prayed and prayed, and no miracle is happening. After this message, I decree by the power of the Holy Ghost that you are free from that marital crisis, that marital bondage. Your husband will locate you. Your suitors will locate you in the name of Jesus Christ. Number three, employing godly virtues to counter satanic attacks on the family. Employing godly virtue to counter satanic attacks on the family. The family is, if the family will be sheltered from satanic attacks, there are some things that must be put in place. There are some things that we must know, that if these things are not there, the devil will find his way. Jesus Christ said, the prince of this world coming and finds nothing in me. If the devil is coming to your family, if he finds the door open, swept and garnished, he will enter inside. If he sees the door open, he will enter inside. If he sees his children inside, he will enter inside. Do you know what the Bible says? The Bible says, he that commits sin is of the devil. And if you are committing sin, what happened? You have opened the door for the devil. And if the devil comes and sees his child inside that family, he has the right to visit his child, my brother. He has his right to visit his friend. And if you know that you are a sinner in the family, you are the black leg. You are the one that is causing the confusion. You are the one that is opening the door. You are the one that is opening the crack. And I pray that after this message, you will repent in dust and ashes, and the door of your family will be closed in the name of Jesus Christ. Those are the things I'm talking about. I want to show you something here. Let me just show you something. You know, number one, you must be born again. You must be born again. If you are not born again, that means you don't have anything to do with God, because those who are still living in sin, they are children of the devil, and the devil has the right to experiment whatever he wants to experiment. Is it sicknesses? He experiment. Is it divorce? He can experiment your family to see whether it works. Is it academic setback? Will experiment in your family to see why, how it works. Is it family? Is it poverty? It will have to try in your family first and to see how it's going to work, how it's going to torment you. You know that the devil is happy when we are suffering. The devil is happy when you are poor. The devil is happy when you are sick. The devil is happy when anything negative is happening in your life. And I pray that God will give us the faith, even that of a mustard seed, that we can pray and we believe God, that we can decree things and they come to pass. And I believe God will help you. And that's what I'm saying here. Verse number 12, John chapter 10, verse chapter 1, verse 12. But as many as received him, he gave them the power to become his sons. And when you become a child of God, a son of God, in the kingdom of God, I'm telling you, brother, sister, every power will come under your feet. The devil will respect. Let me say, the devil respects children of God. He respects servants of God. He respects people who are with fire. Let me tell you, you know, when those seven sons of Scephers, when they caught the man that was possessed of evil spirit, and they brought that man and locked that man in the house and said, we adjure you by the name of Jesus, which we hear Paul preaching. You know what the devil said? Hey, what are you talking about? Paul, I know. Can I hear your amen? May Jesus, let demons recognize you. Let demons recognize you. When your name is called, let Satan pay attention. He said, Paul, I know. Jesus, I know. Who are these ones? Who are these rats? Who are these foolish ones that are here? The Bible said the demons got up and tear their clothes, beat them up, and sent them out wounded. I pray that the devil, your name will be noticed. Because you are already a child of God, the child of the king. When he sees the child of the king, you know, as a child of the president of a country, you don't need to move about and be telling people, you know, I am a son of the president of this country. No, you don't tell people. Immediately you appear in the place, the atmosphere will change. People know. They just know this man is this man. What about in the army? In the army, we have people with ranks. When a colonel appears, it don't need to be announced to people. I'm a colonel. I'm a captain. I am this. No, he doesn't do that. When he appears, he just stands. We just look at his shoulders. Then we begin to give him the respect. The soldiers begin to call cafe. I pray whenever you are name is mentioned in the kingdom of darkness, even the devil will tremble in the name of Jesus. Your family will become a small semi-heaven on earth here. And I believe God help you, you will do that. Get saved, husband get saved, wife get saved, and all this will be over. Then number two, Number two, you must put on the helmet of salvation. That's number two. You must put on the helmet of salvation, which is the protection for your life. Then number three, righteousness. Righteousness is a shield. It's a breastplate. Righteousness. You must put on faith, which will make you to be able to quench down all the fiery doubts of the wicked. Oh my God, you must hold the sword of the Spirit. The sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. You must be filled with the Holy Ghost. When the power of the Holy Ghost is upon your life, when the fire of the Holy Ghost is upon your life, anywhere you go, there will be a manifestation. Anywhere you go, there will be a recognition. Anywhere you go, the devil will tremble. When they hear your name, when they hear you are coming to the city, they will tremble. Demons will pack the loot and transfer from that city. When you transfer to a quarter, demons will transfer. Brother, I'm telling you the truth. When you transfer to any house, demons will also transfer out of that environment. Why is it that we have reached a point in our Christian life? Come on, brother. Where is the power of God? Where is the Jesus we are preaching? That everywhere we go, we are crying of demons, we are crying of affliction, we are crying of torment. Some cannot even do anything because this Satan is tormenting my life. Satan is not doing anything. So you have given yourself to the devil, you have allowed the devil, you have opened the door for him. Let's close the door by the being filled with the Holy Ghost, and the Lord will do all. Constant prayer, consistent prayer. You know, the devil fears prayer, that's why he fights prayer. That's why they're difficult to pray. Because you want to go to pray, the devil knows if I allow this woman to sit down and pray, this will be terrible on me. He will cause your phone to ring. Then you will stand up, you go and answer the call. Before you are coming, another call has come. Then you put in, you say, okay, I'm going to pray in the evening. I'm going to pray. He has just helped you, he has just distracted you so that he can continue with his activity. While you are still praying, and you saw someone knock, pam, 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 pam. Brother, are you there? You know, he didn't use it. Okay, I am there. Instead of keeping quiet and then you are grooming in prayer, after that you say, pray, Lord, you call me while I was praying. But to us today, look at Muslim. If a Muslim man start to pray, as he bow his head and say, Allah, okay, bow. As he bow his head, whether the roof is falling, that man will remain praying. No? That man will not answer for no. But our own Jesus today is the one that when we are praying to Jesus, a man can distract us. We are praying to Jesus, our phones are ringing. Let's put this gadget around. You know, the devil is using all these gadgets. They are good for us, but the devil is using them. Don't allow those gadgets to control you. I pray God will help us. Then, persistent prayer. Number seven, careful watchfulness and vigilance. You know, the Bible says, be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, as a roaring lion, is walking about, is seeking for whom he might destroy. I pray you will not enter your family in the name of Jesus Christ. Come on now, we want to pray. I pray, brother and sister, if your family is already scattered, if the devil has attacked your home and you are now weeping, you are now crying, you don't know what to do, you don't know where to go, it is time for you to rise up now, wherever you are, and start to pray and start to call upon God. If you are a sinner, you repent. You are the black leg in that family. If you are a backslider, repent. You are a black leg in that family. You are the source of affliction in that family. You are the root that the devil is using. You are the crack in the wall. I pray that even right now, wherever you are, if you are a sinner, repent. If you are a sinner, give your life to Jesus. Call Jesus to forgive your sins. Come into your life. And when it comes into your life, you are going to move with that Jesus into the home, and the devil will pack his bag and baggages and will get out of your home. Pray, call upon the name of the Lord. Call upon Jesus. In Jesus' name I pray. And amen. Wherever you are right now, and you know that the devil has attacked your home, and you know that the devil has taken hold of your home, and you know that the devil has taken your home captive, I pray from today in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, wherever your children are right now, that brother, that sister, that pastor, that minister of the gospel, that the devil has invaded your home, I bind the devil in the name of Jesus. I command him by the authority of the Holy Ghost. You send your word, and your word healed, and your word delivered them. Your word will not go and come back void unto you. I send the word God of power into that family, into the family of that sister, into the family of that minister. I chase out the devil in the name of Jesus Christ. I command that the fire of the Holy Ghost will begin to burn in every home, will begin to burn in every family. That demonic spirit that is controlling that woman, that her mouth is running, that her mouth cannot keep Sunday. She can talk from morning to evening. She can argue. She can fight back. That demonic spirit that is keeping that man out of the home, in the bar, everywhere, that command in the name of Jesus, let that power be broken in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh Lord, I pray all the women that Father Divine have been praying to get married, the devil has blocked the way. The devil has put a mask on their face. When men see them, they see a monster. They are running away and they don't know what is happening to them. They are beautiful. They are fine. They have given their life to Jesus, but the devil will not allow them. I bind you in the name of Jesus. I resist your power. I command you, leave their home in the name of Jesus. I release, Father and God, those who are bound and chained by poverty, I release them in the name of Jesus. Those who are bound in marital crisis, I release them in the name of Jesus. I command a fence to be built right their home. Right now, Lord, let there be total freedom. Total freedom. Total liberty. Those runaway children that have escaped from the home and they cannot come back. The devil has barred the way. Those children of the ministers of the gospel that the devil is using to bring the ministers from the pulpit. I bind the devil and I command that hand of the devil upon that young man. Get out in the name of Jesus. I pray, Lord Jesus Christ, let there be freedom right now. Everywhere that this message will go, let there be freedom. Let me get testimonies of what Jesus Christ in your mighty power and mercy is doing. Lord, I pray, perform the miracles to all the listeners of this FM radio in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, because I know your answer. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. God bless your soul.